Hi, welcome back to another edition of Lipper's Fund Flows Insight Report. My name is Tom Roseen. Thanks for joining me today. I'll be reporting flows for the weekend of Wednesday, July 24th, 2019. Investors injected about $23.6 billion into the conventional fund business this week, seventh consecutive week that we've seen net inflows. And this was on some actually rather good news that we had out there. We heard that there was progress in the China-U.S. trade talks. We heard that the federal government actually agreed on something finally, and they're going to go ahead and try to pass through a budget proposal that would stop any sort of freezes on government spending and the like. And then last, we heard some rather good news on the Q2 earnings season, with about 140 some odd constituents S&P 500. We found that about 75% have beaten analyst expectations. This is according to our proprietary research team with the Refinitiv, and that was rather good news. However, investors are still very concerned with the geopolitical issues that are going on with Iran, the Straits of Hormuz, and the like. And so it's going to turn out that we really didn't see a lot of money going to equity funds. In fact, we saw negative outflows, but we did see money going into munis, money market funds, and taxable bond funds. We'll get into some detail here. So why don't we go ahead and turn our attention to the macro groups and see actually how that panned out. Basically, we saw that the macro groups, if we take a look, equity funds were the only real loser, about $5.7 billion in outflows. Taxable bond funds, so about $2.4 billion of inflows. Muni bond funds took in about $2 billion. And by the way, this is the best one-week flow that we've seen since we've been collecting one-week flows since 1992. So really, we've had quite a run on muni bond funds as far as net new money coming in. And then money market funds actually took in $26 billion. And I told you that was really kind of the story. There has been a lot of people heading for the sidelines. And I believe it's because we're seeing a lot of uncertainty in the market, maybe because the market's a little long in the tooth, maybe because we're seeing, China and the U.S. not, you know, really coming out with a trade agreement, or maybe people just aren't trusting these lowered earning estimates and the wins there as well. So we'll just have to keep an eye on that. Let's go ahead now, though, and take a look at the equity universe one by one and just see what's going on with that group. Basically, in the equity universe, we saw a 1.16% return. First week in three, we saw positive returns, but we saw $5.7 billion in outflow, 23rd consecutive week that we've seen outflows. And how this panned out is basically we saw domestic equity funds lose about $4.2 billion. They had a 1.36% positive return. And we saw that that was for the first week in three that we saw that big of a return. And non-domestic equity funds saw about $1.5 billion in outflow, fifth consecutive week they've seen outflows, and they had a fairly handsome return of 0.74%. And this is the second week in three that they've actually saw plus side returns. So if we break this down into a little bit more detail, we see that large cap funds actually handed out back about $2.8 billion. And on the global institutional side, we saw institutional equity funds hand back about $1.1 billion. So let's go ahead and turn our attention now to the ETF side of the equity universe and see what happened there. For the first week in three, we've seen outflows as well, $2.7 billion. So it looks like the retail investor and the authorized participant, the institutional investors that actually create and destroy ETF shares, were in the same mindset. They were in a net redemption mode. We saw the Spider Gold Fund taking about $874 million, a little conservative there. And then we saw Goldman Sachs Active Beta U.S. Law, a large cap fund ETF, basically taking about $791 million. And on the downside, actually for outflows, we saw SPY lose about $5.5 billion. And the Invesco QQQ Trust One saw about $1.3 billion in net outflows. So we did see kind of the bigger funds taking it on the chin. And we saw maybe some of the conservative areas, I don't know if I call the active beta conservative, but the other groups basically taking in net money. Again, it was just on the value-oriented side that we saw that as well. Well, let's go ahead now and turn our attention to the fixed income side of the universe. Fixed income ETFs, took in for the sixth consecutive week net new money, $2.4 billion this week, and it's the first week in three that they actually have plus side returns, 0.33% return. And the major attractor of net new money was the corporate investment grade debt funds. They took in about $1.9 billion, followed by international and global debt funds, which took in about $106 million. Not a lot to write about there, but again, you know, with the Fed becoming a little bit more dovish, we're really seeing a lot of money being plowed back into both taxable and tax-exempt bond funds. Let's go ahead now and turn our attention towards the fixed income ETF side of the business and see what happened with that particular group. When we took a look at the ETFs on this side of the group, we saw that they took in about $1.6 billion, 11th consecutive week that they've taken in net new money. And at the top of the group, we saw the iShares iBox, a high yield dollar corporate bond ETF, taking about $599 million. We saw the Spider Bloomberg Barclays high yield bond ETF taking about $586 million. And on the outflow side, we saw the iShares 1 to 3 year treasury bond ETF lose about $516 million. And we saw the iShares JPM, United States Emerging Market, United States dollar, emerging market bond ETF lose about $343 million. Well, that brings us to our muni bond fund side. And like I said, we've been on a long tear with muni bond funds. And the muni bond funds actually saw about $1.7 billion, a net new money come into their coffers. Now, remember, I told you that it was we've been on a tear and we've had one of the longest runs we've had in many years as far as consecutive inflows here. And again, this one was to $1.7 billion. 29th consecutive week, they've seen net new money come to that group. And it's a sixth consecutive week they've had plus side performance, this time to the tune of 0.13%. Keep in mind, low numbers, this is a muni bond fund and is a weekly number. So high yield muni bond funds actually took in the lion's share of the money, $481 million. And if we take a look at the muni's investment side of the ETF universe, we saw $256 million net new money coming to that group. That brings us to our money market arena right now to take a look at and do a little bit of dissecting there. Money market funds saw about $26 billion even come into their coffers. How it broke out, taxable money market funds saw about $27.6 billion net new money. And if we break that down in institutional retail, we see that the institutional funds took in $20.1 billion. And we see that the retail side took in about $7.5 billion. And tax-exempt money market funds saw about $1.5 billion leave their coffers as investors were moving money back in to the muni bond fund side of the universe, as we just got done talking about. Well, that's basically it for me this week. But basically, we're going to keep our eyes, obviously, on the U.S.-China trade talks that are going on. We have the United States actually going to visit people in China, and we hope to get that back on track. That'll be a big boon if we do that. But we are going to keep a careful eye on what earnings come out over the next week or two. This is one of the busiest weeks that we have for reporting season. And again, the numbers have been pretty good for earnings and on sales. So again, if things go the way they're going, if the Fed does, in fact, people are going to keep an eye on the Fed coming up. The 30th, 31st is going to be the Fed fund meeting, the FOMC meeting, to see if they're going to actually cut 25 basis points. And if that does happen, we do feel that there's going to be more inflows into equity funds. But again, people this week were very, I'm not going to call it risk averse as much as just doing a wait and see, sitting on the sidelines. Well, if I didn't do a deep enough dive for you, you can go to our site at www.lipperusfundflows.com, or you can join us next week when one of our analysts will talk to you about the weekly flow trends. Thanks for joining me. My name is Tom Roseen, wishing you the best in your wealth planning and creation.